stuck in his head, couldn't get rid of it. He didn't write it with that in mind, he just said he couldn't get rid of it. And because that's all he could think about while he was writing it, that's why this piece got this name. So,
just that way.
So now we're going to move from a trio, to a marimba quartet. This is Raspberry Tango. They don't know what I'm going to tell them either. There's only me in this room now that knows the theme of this piece of house. So just bear with us in about 7 minutes now, 5 to 7 minutes. I'll then give you, I'll reveal what the theme and the ideas are for the improv. Thank you. those themes and what we're going to do here, this one's going to be three staged. We're going to go from four individuals to a team. You saw the first piece we had, Trio per Uno, Trio for One. We've had quartets where four people working together to create a marimba quartet. So we're going to emulate that now. We have four individuals. So the start of this is going to be any instrument you like, but individual. Then we're going to go into split it into twos. So I'm not going to tell you which split the ladder up with, but you're going to go into twos. And then whatever instrument you play has to be done as a team. So we don't have any, but if we had crash cymbals here, for example, you'd have one person holding one, one person holding another. Gives you an idea, right? And then eventually you're going to morph into all four of you playing the same instrument. And for this, I've chosen the tom-tom. So you can travel wherever you want across the stage, play wherever you want, work as teams, and then go to that. So these guys cannot communicate verbally to do this. They're going to have to do this musically and through eye contact and musical communication. We're going to see if they can manage that. So this is improvisation, this is 14, this one would be. This is improvisation 14, composed by Kevin, Maria, Sebastian, and Nazir. Thank you.
Team goes.
is. For example, one of the pieces he's written is called Pendulum Music, which is actually a piece of music written for microphones to be suspended over speakers, and then they would be swung back and forth like a pendulum, so you get the feedback. And as the microphone would go past the speaker, the feedback would be louder. And all of these different microphones for different chord lengths would swing at different speeds, and the piece would then end where all of the microphones were hanging directly above the speakers, and the feedback was at its highest sound, and the highest pitch. So that's the type of composer that this gentleman is. One of the big pieces he's written for percussion music is music for pieces of wood, which is a rather lengthy piece of music for five percussionists, where one person starts playing on the beat all the time, and then the next person joins in. It's all written down, but he adds a note, repeats that over and over again. Then he'll add another note specified in the music, and then he'll repeat that until it's comfortable, and so on and so forth. So he's fully joined in with his groove, and then each player is introduced like that until it becomes a hypnotic rhythm, which then gets changed again and altered further and further. This piece takes the idea of phasing, and that combines them together. Now, what this composer does with phasing is he moves a musical phrase by an eighth note each time. So this piece is based on a motif. It's clapping music, so everything's being clapped. So Ken is going to show us the rhythm. The first thing that's being played is a group of three notes, followed by two, followed by one, back to two. And that then gets looped over and over and over again. We're going to add in between each of those, we're going to put one note of equal value rest. It becomes 12 notes. The rhythm then sounds like this. So that's 12 actual notes. He plays nine of them. Eight. Plays eight of them, four of the rest. So then one player plays that over and over again, loops that. That's going to be in the Zia's one. What Kevin's going to do then is he's going to displace it, he's going to morph it by one note each time. Bring it closer and closer and closer. He's going to do that 12 times. Phase it 12 times until it eventually gets back to where he started. And that's where the piece will end. This is Steve Rice's clapping music. Thank you. intimidating, you might think, well, there's maybe a lot of 5-1, 5-1 all the time, which is what Tippy is maybe used for. In this situation, however, he really has made a melody for the Tippy to play, and then developed it in many, many different ways. With normal Tippy sticks, there's going to be, as well as using snare sticks, and other things which you'll see along the way. It will start off with a slow introduction, and then a rather fast little tang onto that, leading to the first cadenza section. The melody is then presented and then developed further from there. We go through several lengthy cadenza sections before the final coda, where everyone comes together to play a nice exciting end. So to perform for tonight, the John Beck Timpani Concerto, please welcome Maria Toledo. Thanksgiving and holiday season coming up, and we will see us again in the